Well, Gene and Scott, just about an hour ago, David Cobb walked through those doors behind us, a free man. But for the past 11 years, he's been in prison. And during that time, the prosecution says he had every opportunity to enroll in a sexual offender plan, or program, that is. But Cobb never did, partly because he says he was only convicted of attempted sexual assault and therefore didn't qualify.
Sure.
Are you prepared to go back to prison if that's what the judge decides?
I've been there before.
With his fate still in question, 71-year-old David Cobb walks out of court, still a free man for now. Out of prison since June when he was let out after 11 years, convicted in 1995 of attempted sexual assault and possession of pornography. This after Farmington police found him with the 12-year-old victim and a backpack full of porn and a pumpkin mask.
He got released on June 22nd and he did every day of his time.
But what he didn't do while in prison is complete a sexual offender program.
From 1999 until his release, he continued to be given opportunities until he finally said, I don't intend to do it.
Now the prosecution wants him thrown back in jail for another year, saying without that treatment, Cobb may do it again.
Are you a danger to the public as they insinuated in there?
No.
Now the judge has to interpret Cobb's 1995 sentencing, deciding issues like whether treatment was a recommendation or a requirement,
right,
and whether Cobb should go back to jail.
But going back to jail doesn't seem to concern him anyway.
He just feels as though he's been beat up, and the system is pretty powerful, and what's going to happen is going to happen. He's more fatalistic about it. Nothing he can do kind of thing. It's going to happen if the judge decides it's going to happen. And
Cobb's attorney says even if he were to go back to jail, it would be for a year, and he says, the attorney does, that he'd probably only serve two-thirds of that time. Don't forget, Cobb is 71 and reportedly has asthma. His attorney says that would make him a costly inmate to lock up. We're live outside the Stratford County Courthouse in Dover. I'm Josh Davis, WMUR News 9.